Hey, what's up, everyone? Neo Scyther here, getting back to my WWE 2K16 My Career Mode series. And where we last left off, we just finished up the first three of our tutorial matches, where I had a singles match against Enzo Amore, which is just more training than anything, then a match against Tyler Breeze, then I teamed up with Baron Corbin against the Vaude Villains. Between all of that, I actually went ahead and I double-checked my entrance. My entrance looks fine. I went ahead and fixed my moveset, so my moves are different. I changed my finisher, found what my exhibition mode finisher was called. So we're going to pick up where we left off here, and it is time for my first actual match on NXT, which they are still having me team with Baron Corbin against Finn Balor and Hideo Itami. Hey, we're not the only match on the card this time. I find it funny that the first match is Darren Young versus Stardust. The third match is Tyler Breeze versus Curtis Axel. Then you got Adam Rose versus Bo Dallas. Simon Gotch versus Titus O'Neil. I'll give that to Titus because he did briefly return to NXT. But even still, Rusev versus Jack Swagger. Fandango versus Owens versus Zayn versus Neville. So, I just need to put this out there. This is why they need a bigger NXT presence in this game. Especially female wrestlers, because all of the matches have at least one person who was on the main roster when this game came out. If not, all the competitors were on the main roster when this game came out. Okay, so I would like to simulate the next event. Okay, there we go. Simulates the matchup to my next event. Okay. And yes, I fixed the jukebox to where all the music are entrance themes. So, probably after this match, since I'm explaining a bit here, a bit of exposition, I guess you could say, I will probably just go straight into the entrances of the competitors in following matches. Just kind of save some time. Or when stuff like this happens. That's right. I'm ready for my NXT debut. The future has arrived. Hopefully. Hopefully I don't just fall flat on my face, but...
You think you know me?
I will say, the parts of my entrance, they do look a little weird because I'm using multiple superstars' entrances.
The combination of these two competitors looks nearly unstoppable.
You'd be hard-pressed to find a better tag team match than we're about to see here.
I was a little surprised that there was no name announcement. But then again, I've had that happen with this before. I don't think it's a... I mean, I think it is an issue with the game. It's not like, okay, well, to kind of build up the fact that it's my debut, we're not going to announce his name. We're just going to let him bask in the glory of the moment. No, I've had moments where, in exhibition matches, where for whatever reason, the names were not announced. In fact, there was nothing, not even from the commentators, during any of the entrances. See, again, after this match, I'll probably just go to... If there's any backstage segments, I will show those between matches, obviously. But in terms of, like, the loading screens and all that, or anything where I alter movesets or my entrance or my attributes, I won't actually show that in the video. I'll just go straight to the next match or backstage segment. So yes, I am once again teaming with Baron Corbin. I don't know if this is a constant thing for my career mode, if you constantly start out as a heel teaming with Baron Corbin.
WWE's finest, squaring off in what will assuredly be an exciting tag team encounter.
Make no mistake about it, this match will be one for the ages.
I bet you say that about all the matches, don't you, Cole? I also find it weird that at least in 2K15, you were constantly starting off against literally like nameless jobbers. And of course, you got to give him credit here for getting the entrances down as well as they did. But anyways, in 2K15, you started out just against some nameless jobbers and worked your way up. I actually got stuck in a match against Titus O'Neil. Though I did eventually win the NXT Championship, I lost it like the very next match to Sami Zayn, and I got it back against Sami Zayn the very next match. Here, they're just starting me right out in a tag team match with Baron Corbin against Hideo Itami and the NXT Champion. I love NXT to death. I think it's awesome. A lot of the times it's better than the main roster. Or at least that was my impression prior to people like Owens, Zayn, so on getting called up recently. Okay, I guess Owens was last year. But you would never see someone debut against the NXT Champion. So for anyone wondering, since I mentioned it, if I would be... Okay, first of all, I mean, I got a couple things to mention here in just a minute, but if anyone's wondering if I'm going to be including entrances for all the matches, I probably will, just so it feels a little more authentic.
From Tokyo, Japan, weighing in at 182 pounds, Hideo Itami.
The combination of these two competitors looks nearly unstoppable.
They've been buzzing about this one ever since this match was announced.
It's going to be an ongoing joke, but I bet you say that about all the matches, don't you, Cole? But, so a couple things to mention. In the video prior to this, my first video, I mentioned about, I hope that Enzo Amore returns soon from his injury he incurred at Payback? Yeah, I'm getting my pay-per-views mixed up. And obviously he has. I made a note of that in the video description. Second, I really need to catch up on NXT. I don't think Hideo Itami has returned from injury yet. When he does, if Balor would ever turn heel, I would like to see Balor and Itami for the title. In the meantime, they make a pretty good team, though.
And there's the bell. I think what we could see here is a classic chess match between these guys. I mean, one that's going to take power, speed, and aggression to win.
From our vantage point, it doesn't even look like a
camel clutch locked in, wrenching on the neck and lower back.
And yeah.
Well, he might have been losing some of his...
I don't mind
anyway.
Using submissions. I'm not going to use him as a finisher, though, because... Ooh, nice reversal. Because I still hate this game's submission system badly.
Particularly his basement dropkick in the corner. The way that he floats through the air prior to impact.
Excuse me, he did not just hit me in the back.
As we watch Finn Balor, let's get your take on him.
I respect that even though the title's not on the line, the champ appears to be battling like this is the most important match...
I hope the title's not on the line. This is a tag team match, after all.
It's a sign of a winner.
What's he gonna do here? What's he gonna do here? There's the suplex.
This is gonna be bad if I lose this badly in my NXT debut.
This guy's a machine.
Oh man, look at his face. The pain has to be crippling.
Just a dominating display.
If that's how I'm probably gonna lose a good chunk of my matches, is via submission.
If there's one place you don't want to get pummeled, it's your face.
No kidding. Ooh, that's hurting me.
I like the way you described Finn Balor earlier, King.
Really?
Graceful. It's so true. And it's amazing how he could be both graceful and impactful at the same time. His Pele kick comes to mind when thinking of moves that are both graceful and impactful.
Into the second rope and, missed the splash.
DDTs. It's like he was born to be a WWE superstar.
Not that I meant to do that, but you know what?
You have to have a special.
Won't let me get a leg layered on you? Absolutely, I'll do it.
Attack like that.
I hope you didn't think these guys like each other.
So I was trying to get a tag in, but I didn't want to get right back in. I was afraid he's going
to
have a stun rather quickly. Okay, I'm not losing this match by count out. Come on, get off me, Tommy.
Ever since he came to the
I will try to provide commentary during these matches, but I'm not the greatest at providing commentary.
Maybe anybody else on the roster.
He's bringing it back inside the ring now.
I can't blame him. Keep it in the ring.
I'm trying to keep it in. I'm trying to get back in the ring so I can tag out.
We've seen some great tag team action over the years here in WWE, and I can attest that this is no different.
Get my butt handed to me here.
God, there was nothing accurate about that attempted offense.
Oh, you'd be too.
No, because that attempted offense is me trying to get back in the ring.
Words to describe what we just witnessed. Four. How much pain?
Wait!
There's no escape.
I should not be playing a submission mini game on the outside. Why am
guys just going from one pain?
Why am I getting the option to submit on the outside?
He does have a wide array of offense, King, as you mentioned before. And for me, I'm most amazed at his variety of kicks.
No, you got that right, Cole. Especially his roundhouse kick. I mean, that thing is lethal.
Get out. Come on, come on, get up.
Tommy, do you think he picked up steam here or what?
Get
this
up.
This attack is an amazing display of Hideo's ability.
All right, I'm out.
The range of emotions.
Come on, Baron, do what I couldn't, please.
It's almost an unknowing of what to expect.
I know. I mean, I got goosebumps. This match is going to be so unpredictable. I just can't wait. Baron Corbin is just so talented. This match has gone his way incredibly fast here.
That's good, because I'm having trouble getting anything going.
These competitors will always be looking to unleash their finishing maneuver, and when that happens, the complexion of the match can change in a heartbeat.
You're right about that. The entire match can end in a heartbeat if somebody hits their big move. Looks like somebody wants back in this match.
I don't know. Baron's got things under control. I'm fine. Yep, sorry. My bad.
Wait, nice reversal.
No, get up there.
Dishing out some serious punishment here.
Wait, I gotta be over toward
is
the corner.
He still conscious? Man, that looked bad.
Come on, Baron, get over here.
The quick reversal there by Baron Corbin.
Looks like somebody wants back in this match. Looks like somebody wants back in this match.
And now he's back out on the apron.
Oh, here we go.
He's trying to mangle his face here.
Yeah, that's right, Tommy.
One of these guys is going to walk away with the win here tonight. I just can't imagine one of them also accepting defeat.
Ooh, there's a nice reversal.
Going for the cover.
See, I know it's not going to put away the NXT champion.
He's taking damage to the back of the head that render most men completely immobile.
Whoop.
And he may be
that was a mistake.
Finn Balor, and it's up. He got the shoulder up.
I am drama. I kicked out a zero.
We're looking at complete domination here.
He's seen enough. Here he comes.
Oh, this is not good. This is not good. Speak.
He's just getting dissected. Timber, and he falls hard.
Not today, too fast. We're looking at complete domination here.
That's right.
Oh, looking to make a statement here.
And Davidson gets all of it.
Ouch, that had to hurt. Uh-oh, look at this.
And now, the burning hammer.
Nobody comes back from this.
His partner's being punished and he's seated up. Now that's a finishing move. This thing might be...
The shoulders are down.
And this one's set to break loose.
Will this be enough?
Hang on.
Nope, not quite.
Reversing it. Incredible.
Finn Balor, totally vulnerable at this point.
Yep, that's why I hate submissions.
Watch it.
What strength, fighting his way out. Better check for loose teeth.
Ow.
Kick to the face.
No kidding. I think he may have lost a molar.
Oh, this isn't good. This is not good. No, 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 please, no.
Watch it.
The coup de grace.
Oh, jeez. Baron, you better get your butt in here.
Does the coup de grace mean this thing's over?
Whew.
The ref gets absolutely flattened.
Not what I'm sure was intended, but thank you. Oh, thanks a lot, Baron.
The tension, the drama, this is electric.
Look at the back of my arm, Cole. Look at the goosebumps. I love this. Ooh, face first.
Oh, that'll take the wind right out of you.
He sees it.
He gets the comeback moment. I'm the one down on my back.
Wait a minute. It's not over yet. He's still got some fight left. He's clawing his way back into this match. He's delivering an old-fashioned butt-kicking right here. Thinking to avoid that. Baron Corbin gets the tag.
He's got it locked in. Will this be it? Oh, the longer he stays in this, the closer he is to losing the match. I guess he's done with that move.
Yeah, but what's he going to do next?
Look, yeah, just take care of Balor there. And I'll take care of Tommy.
I don't know if we've ever seen someone in...
Camel clutch applied. And man, is he pulling back on that neck.
Seems like these guys are letting out a lot of pent-up frustration tonight. Oh my, Baron Corbin.
He now I meant to do.
Right here.
I think this is it.
I was trying to get up on the apron, not... Yeah. I'm not trying to take the darn steps
so
apart.
This has been a very competitive tag team match.
Yeah, these are two top-tier teams. I wouldn't expect anything less from them.
And there's the submission hold. Will this do it?
Great hold being applied.
And there's the release. What's going to happen now?
I'm scared to ask.
So, yes, if you have not noticed, something I've realized about this game is that... If you're on the outside, or if you're in a tag match, you're not active, and you're the just running around the outside, your percent will go down. If you're on the ring apron, it'll go up, apparently.
Come
on, Baron, you got another day stored up.
Hey, what do you want for your last meal?
There's the switch. Today, too fast.
You gotta move quicker than that.
wasn't hurt before, it certainly is now.
And it's going to be hurting for a while. I don't like how slow. Whoa!
Fine, I'll get back out of the ring.
Good grief! How is he still conscious? The shoulders are down!
And the shoulders up.
And the match continues.
No, the shoulder wasn't up.
And the ref starts the count.
The tag team scene here in WWE is undergoing a bit of a renaissance, and it's because of action like this. He gets the tag.
Not trying to do that. I'm trying to get off the side and get my hand out so I can get back in this match.
Somebody wants back in this match. Yep, there's the reversal by Finn Balor. Looks like somebody wants back in this match.
Duh, I went back in this match.
What a punch!
Oh, what a shot. That did some serious damage.
Come on.
You can't take too many of those and expect to be in the match much longer.
So damaging.
I think it's gut check time now. Wow, he's still down after that.
Yeah, and I'm trying to get in so
he's
I can protect you there, Balor. It's not good.
Finn Balor scores with a tremendous move. Look at this. There's a hand into the cover.
He's seen it up. Here he comes.
The ref's out.
My goal is not to wallop the ref. I just want to stop
and
the count.
From Baron Corbin.
I'm trying to get on the dang apron.
Look at this energy from Finn Balor. Look at these moves. This is awesome. I don't know how he does it. I've been in the business a long time, and I haven't seen anyone with the energy and ability of Finn Balor.
That's my main issue with tag team matches. I just want to get back on the apron, not get back in the ring.
Some damage has been dished out, but certainly not enough to assume this one's even close to being over.
And there's the count.
Hey, I'm actually back
up on the of a highly efficient and highly effective strike. What placement?
Whoa! A direct hit. Talk about getting tagged and knocked in the middle of next week.
Yep, there's the reversal by Finn Balor.
That's like, yeah, this match isn't going too well.
Could this be it?
I think so.
Two.
Thank God it wasn't.
These competitors trying to keep their wits about them.
Well, Cole, it's so important not to lose your cool in a match like this, not to lose your focus. You make a mistake, and I guarantee you, your opponent is going to capitalize on it. He wants back in this match in the worst way. When he gets going like this, there are a few better. Oh, wait, nice reversal.
This is not going good.
Hey, Tommy reversing it. Incredible.
Just making his presence felt there.
He makes the tag.
Come on, Baron.
Looks like
you're starting to annoy me as a tag team partner.
He's certainly showing us something.
There's the cover. Can
Get
he do it?
In.
He's got it.
That's it. Nope. It's like I'm sitting here pounding on the left bumper and I can't get back in the ring.
I just can't get over the physicality of this match. This has been brutal.
Brutal and very, very painful for these guys.
Finn Balor is in position. The coup de grace is going to be the coup de grace.
Does the coup de grace mean this thing's over?
Nope.
And the ref starts the count.
A lot of pride on the line here in this tag team encounter, but
come
only
on,
two
Baron,
of these competitors
get
lined
out
up
of there.
What they came for, the win.
Oh,
This is a level of destruction no one was expecting.
No kidding. This is getting ugly.
You're telling me this is getting ugly.
Versus
a sling blade. Oh, come on.
His shoulders are down.
Okay, that was a heightened drama because, you know.
The referee getting involved now.
2 3/4, yeah.
And there's the count. And the ref starts the count. Oh, out of nowhere!
And this has got to be it.
Yeah, maybe.
Nope, got a rope break. That rope break ability. Can you do it again?
He thinks he has it.
And there are the ropes.
Ah.
These guys giving this sold-out crowd exactly
what
they
came to see.
Break
as well, I'd imagine.
What a camel clutch! He needs to figure out a way to get to his base and break the hold.
Absorbing a little bit of.
Holy crap! I won by submission.
Overly concerned about though.
I just made the NXT champion submit to a camel clutch. Holy crap. So yeah, I know I am terrible at in-match commentary, but I'll try to throw in what I can when I can, but that was just a shocker. I mean, I didn't even think I was going to get tagged back into the match to begin with. Let alone being able to get a camel clutch on Finn Balor, the NXT champion, and then making him tap out to a friggin' camel clutch. I will take all the victories I can get.
And here's some highlights from the matchup.
That doesn't mean I'm going to change my finisher to a submission. Heck no.
Here are your winners. The X-Factor, Russell Davidson, and Baron Corbin.
I love a good tag team match, and this one was unforgettable. I mean, these teams gave us everything they had, and the WWE Universe is the true winner in this one.
And don't forget you and I. We have the best seats in the house. Now that's having a game plan and executing it to perfection.
Thank you for tuning in tonight, folks. We hope enjoyed that great match.
So the relationship changed down at the bottom. I'm still trying to figure that out. Does that mean they're more towards face now, or one towards heel? I don't know. I'm still alignment of a heel with a prideful personality. Not bad overall, I'll take that.
Please join me in welcoming my guest tonight. Let's talk about what happened out there tonight. You just finished your first match in an NXT arena. So how did it feel?
Oh, I gotta read this. I didn't even realize the first time... This is the first time you'll get to speak in front of a WWE audience. Depending on which speech you pick, it will change your own personality. As personality changes, you'll have different potential tag team partners and rivals.
Woo! What a match! I'm so excited I could go for a second match right now. Today, I learned that this is where I belong. That I am a WWE superstar, and I am going to give it my all until I reach that title. Let's do this!
And because of that, I turned face.
There you have it. Back to you guys.
Nothing against Renee Young. They could have made her look a little better in this game. Superstar 1-1. My tag team won. We'll keep, So if I was a superstar 1 or 2-1, like, you can't put the actual name. That finishes that up. We will go on through now to the next NXT event. Congratulations, you've gained enough popularity from your first few matches to go up a rank in the NXT Championship rankings. Keeping into rivalries and winning matches to continue up the rankings to become the number one contender and earn a shot at the NXT Championship. Sorry, Simon. We can also see what's going on in the rest of the title scenes here. Yeah, John Cena overall 95, no kidding. Ryback, time players. Seth Rollins. Of course, won't show the women's or the Divas Championship because, yeah, obvious reasons. So next up, I have a one-on-one match against Neville. I am actually going to spend my few skill points. Actually, no, I'm not going to spend the skill points. I really don't have much I can improve. So we're going to go into our one-on-one match against Adrian Neville, and we'll be back with that in just a moment.
You think you know me?
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Columbus, Ohio. The X Factor, Russell Davidson.
Well, this superstar has all the tools needed to win this one. Now let's see if he can put them together.
Love the passion this competitor brings to the ring each and every week.
Even though this is only my second week in an NXT arena.
Brawl,
Maggle. A little bit interesting if they actually got an NXT commentary team to commentate on NXT matches. I mean, heck, give me an NXT match with even if Corey Graves were to go solo commentary, I'll take that.
Let's just call it for what it is, an all-out...
Uh-oh. Do you see who's coming
really?
Out? Really? I don't like the looks of this.
Not every move is designed to get the fans off their feet.
Oh, wait. Nice reversal. Oh!
Yeah, that's right. I'm not going to let Breeze get the best of me.
Oh, they couldn't find a home for that one.
Well, it certainly wasn't due to a lack of trying, Michael.
Tell us about Neville. It might be worth mentioning a little bit about Davidson here.
Definitely looking confident in this one-on-one environment. We're going to find out a lot here tonight. Head-to-head, no excuses. Let's get it on. Definitely looking confident in this one-on-one environment. That's a good sign.
The shoulders are down.
And he breaks the cover, forcing the referee.
See, I'm not sure if breaking out of a pin will actually like make them lose stamina or not. That was kind of my goal there. Let's see if I make them lose a little bit of stamina.
You can bet every superstar on the roster is crowded around the monitors in the back to see which one of these guys comes out victorious. What is this? Why does he have to get involved in what was otherwise a really good matchup? Good lord, that wasn't even close.
So that is like being
I didn't even punch him.
Really going to work here, just wrenching that thing.
Just a dominating display. Yeah.
I had to use up my stamina on that, but
punishment inflicted here.
Oh.
Oh, it looks like he's in no man's land here. He needs to be able to put things back together here.
Michael, this is a dangerous position to be in. He needs to be able to...
I thought I had more than one taunt. Apparently, I don't.
And regroup. He's too good inside the ring to be out on the floor for long.
I don't agree with you, King. Now back to the ring. He's inflicting some serious pain here.
Well, Gamma Clutch worked the first time.
Clutch locked in, wrenching on the neck and lower back. Oh, out of nowhere.
Ow. That's right, Neville. This is my time. I am the future of NXT, even though I'm technically now a face. And that sounded more like a heel move or heel speech. Yeah, just go with it.
Going in.
Let him get a couple moves in on me.
Fighting from a position of full health here. We're looking at complete domination here.
Oh,
and
really?
From Neville.
Watch out here.
You'll be taking up shots to the back of the head sooner or later. You're going to be seeing stars.
Yeah, or at least looking up at the lights.
We're looking at complete domination here. Oh, my.
Look at the standing red arrow.
Truly amazing moves in this. Here's the...
And he escapes with a kick out. People have been wanting to see these guys go at it for a long time, and by the sound of this crowd, I think they're getting what they wanted.
Oh, wait, nice reversal.
Look out.
There's a sling
There's
blade.
A target on that back.
It only takes a couple of those to bring his night to an end.
Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy. Oh, let's hope this doesn't turn into a two-on-one situation.
There we go.
Gosh. Wait, is he still conscious? Man, that looked bad. Man. He's still down after that move. I almost wonder if his bell got seriously wrong there.
We've seen this before.
Ignore the ding-dong on the ground.
And Davidson gets all of it.
Ouch, that had to hurt.
This is what makes him so dangerous.
The shoulders are down. Dude, what is this?
Really, Breeze?
Match? Come on, someone needs to escort him away from ringside.
Knocked the breath out with a crushing kick to the gut.
I wouldn't be able to breathe for a week.
Really?
And he's heading back in.
I can't blame him. Nothing good is going to happen out here on the floor.
This is genius. He knows how to turn the tide of a matchup, even from ringside.
If he continues to get his way like this, the match will easily become one-sided.
Look out! Oh, my! We've really seen one amazing move after another in this.
Oh, no, 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 no. This is not good. This is not good. Aha.
Not today, too fast. A quick reversal there by Neville. Boom!
Nice blockbuster by Neville.
Quick thinking to avoid that.
Take a famouser, and so I think he ejected Tyler from ringside.
Whoa!
He could pin his
one
right here.
Two,
and it's up.
Nope.
Got the shoulder up. You can't teach heart. Believe me when I tell you, this guy is filled with it.
Nope, you can't teach that. Enzo Amore pun.
Camel clutch locked in, wrenching on the neck and lower back. This is not the position you want to be in.
I hate the submission system.
Look, he's still going. How is this possible?
Neville connecting there with a good shot.
Oh, what a shot. That did some serious damage. You can't take too many of those and expect to be in the match much longer.
What a match.
Reversal there by Neville. Oh, out of nowhere. The quick reversal
Jeez.
There by Neville.
stay down. I will definitely give up. Whoa.
Shoulders down. Is it enough?
It may be.
Two.
A quick reversal there by Neville.
High risk.
Oh, this is not good because I don't have a reversal for this.
Oh.
Okay. I thought I was going to go for the red arrow.
Domination here.
When you're beat up, the last thing you want to have to deal with is this amount of power.
When this guy's on, look out. Not today, too fast.
Hey, he's going for it again.
Up handle slam.
Oh man, that had to hurt.
Come on.
Looking for all the glory here.
Two. Three.
He did not see the rope. Oh, that was beautiful. So I wonder if they have a program that's going to play into things, because again, the whole rope break ability, where you reach out and grab the ropes, the ref may not see it. It actually says that in the description, that the ref may not see that.
Look at this. This was a match that was simply mesmerizing.
Yeah, I had him there if it wasn't for Breeze pulling the ref out of the ring. And yes, take a look at this nice highlight that you can't see behind these cardboard squares. I'll tell you what, I used the Famouser at least half a dozen times. My Famouser is Dean Ambrose's rebound clothesline. I'm tending to use it quite a bit.
We got a couple of highlights here. Let's check them out.
I didn't necessarily mean to go for the pump handle slam. I was actually aiming for the Blue Thunder Bomb. You can see here, Neville grabs the ropes, but the ref's not in position to see it.
Here's your winner, the X-Factor, Russell Davidson.
Not the greatest of matches, only 3.5 stars, but yeah, I'll take it.
Either way, nobody has anything to be ashamed of in this one.
Yeah, you're right. It's just a shame that someone had to lose. Wow.
When relationship changes based on the outcome of your match. You can see how a given relationship changes based on the blinking bars. Red means the relationship is bad, blue means the relationship is good. So, my relationship with Baron Corbin is better, except I'm a face and he's a heel. At least that we now know what that means. So it means I have a bad relationship with Tommy, Neville, Balor, Slater, and pretty much Breeze hates my guts.
Please welcome my guest tonight.
Fine.
Let's talk about Tyler Breeze. He ambushed you tonight during your own match. Have anything to share on that?
Darn right I do.
I know what he's trying to do, and it's not going to work. I'm a professional. He can't get me off my game. I tell you what, if he wants to come at me, then let's do this in the ring in a sanctioned match. We'll see what he's really about.
Thanks for the time. Back to you.
Okay, so with that said, I think this is where we're going to end this video.
It's a new day! Yes, it is!
Once we get through and simulate to the next event. Yay, Rusev beat the crap out of Tyler Breeze. It's what you get for interfering in my match. So next week, naturally, I will probably have against Tyler Breeze, I'm sure. Naturally, against Tyler Breeze. I doubt my rankings went anywhere. Nope, I'm still number 9. If I knock off Tyler Breeze, that probably put me up to the next ranking. No current tag partner or rival. Though I'm sure here in a bit I'm going to have Tyler Breeze as a rival. So that's where I'm going to stop this for now. I thank you guys for watching. And when we come back next time, we'll have a couple more NXT matches. At least one against Tyler Breeze. Who knows where I'm going to go from there. So with that, I thank you guys for watching. And I will see you next time.